Hello and welcome to Kemper Bushcraft and welcome to my series Kemper Camp, and this is episode 7. I'm out here today, it's Saturday, and I have a plan about the ants that are beginning to awake from the winter hibernation. And beside the issue about my anthill, I have a couple of other things I would like to show you. So hang on. Yeah, and as you can see, the ant has finally come up off the ground, and my larvae tent is very close to the anthill. So I have a plan, and I'll show you what it is. Hang on. Many of my subscribers have advised me to use this. It's called Borax, and I bought 0.5 liters. And it's powder, and some of the subscribers told me that I should make a water solution of it and sprinkle it around my larvae tent. So I'll do that, but to be on the safe side, I'll put a little of this powder too around my tent, my larvae, and this is step one in my attempt to get rid of the ants in my camp. I'm not interested in killing them at all, so this will prevent them, hopefully, to go down to my larvae, and they will stay up in their anthill. And I have another plan I'll tell you about in a minute, so hang on. This is my second part of the plan. In here I have some sugar, and I'm going to drill a couple of holes in this so that the ants can come in there and get the sugar. And there's a lid on so that when it's rain it doesn't get wet. I think this is okay. You have to be very big ants if they can't come in here. Yeah, and then I will make a trail from the anthill that is over there and down here, where I will put this little bucket with sugar in. So hang on. Yeah, I think this would be a perfect place. And I'll put it here. And then I can fill it up when it's empty. I'm crossing my fingers for this will be a solution. There's not many ants over at my larvae tent, so at the moment I'm not worried about them, but I don't know. Of course I have to not put food on the ground so they can taste it or smell it. So I have to be careful about anything I bring out here that is eatable for ants. But now I'll see if I can avoid the ants to go down to my larvae and make them go up in the forest to get some sugar instead. I hope so. Well, we'll see. I'll keep you updated. Of course I will.
Well, in this forest there are some birch trees, and I would like to have some sap from one of these trees. So this is my handrail, one of my handrails. I will make a hole into the tree, and this is a piece of bamboo I have from home, and I will carve it so it fits the hole that I'm making. And I'll show you how it's done, and then I will put my solo stove pot under it so it will be catching the sap. And this little piece of bamboo I have cut in this angle at home, and of course it is hollow inside. Now I'm going to split it down in the middle. Yeah. Now I have this, and I'm going to make it thin in this end so that I can adapt it to the hole I'm drilling into the birch trees. Yeah, you can see it's the same size as my drill. I think this will do.
Perhaps this tree is too big, too large, too old. I can see a tree up there. Perhaps it's better. Let's go up there and see. Yeah, I think this tree will be perfect. It has a good size and it's a young tree. So I'll do it here, approximately.
The sap is already beginning to come out. And I have to drill into the middle of the tree, so about, well, I don't know, 2 inch. I guess 5 centimeters. This is fine. Then I'll put this in. I think I'm going to carve a little bit down there. Well, now it's beginning to float. And then I'm going to tie this to the tree so it can drip down in this. It's working nicely.
come back in a couple of hours and see how much birch sap that is in my pot.
Skål.
Just a piece of pizza from last night, so I have a little lunch out here. And a German beer called Mecklenburg Pilsner.
Yeah.
I've decided to make another pot hanger system out of these branches. This one and this one. I'm going to make it so I can adjust it like my with my change. Well, it starts to looking nice. I think I'll take all the bark off. Yeah, now I've made my first. It's going to hang there. And I'm making three. So I have three levels I can adjust it to. So this is the first pot hanger I made. I'm going to make two. It's going to hang here, and then I can adjust it in three levels. As you can see, it's working. Perhaps I'll cut these off. They don't have to be that big. But I think it's gonna work.
Yeah, and now I'm finished. You can see my two pot hangers, and I still have the chains that I can use if I want to. But until now, until then, I'll try to use these adjustable pot hangers too. Yeah, and now I think it's time for a cup of coffee.
Whoa. Thank you.
Well, this was not much, and the ants are down there, so I don't know why this tree is completely dry now, you can see. Well, that's the way it is. I think I'm going to try it on the bigger tree next time I'm out here. Now I'm going to seal it. This will do. Well folks, this is all for now. Thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft and my series Kimber Camp. Hope you enjoy this little video. Unfortunately my project with birch sap didn't succeed. I got a little amount of sap, but not enough so I couldn't drink it. It's been a wonderful day out here. As you have seen, the weather was very nice, about 15 degrees Celsius. The spring is definitely here in Denmark. I hope you're having a nice weekend, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.